morning, students. So there is one basic question: is there any total internal reflection in rainbow or not? So as we all know that rainbow is formed due to refraction, and reflection probably total internal reflection, as most of the people think, and it is given on many websites, in many of the books it is written that T.I.R, and of course dispersion. So there is no doubt about refraction and dispersion, but there is one doubt that whether it is simply reflection or it is total internal reflection that is taking place inside the water droplet. Okay, so let's first quickly revise how to apply Snell's law for two surfaces. For example, suppose there is one surface interface which is separating the transparent medium. Now I am calling the refractive index of the medium 1 is N1 and the refractive index of medium 2 as N2. So light, let's say, coming from medium N1 to medium N2 like this. So when the light is coming like this, let's draw a normal. This is my normal, and assuming that N2 is greater than N1, it means this medium is denser as compared to the medium in which from which light is coming. So the light ray will bend like this. Okay, it doesn't go straight, it slightly deviates from its straight line path. So if this angle is theta 1 and this angle is theta 2, then Snell's law relates theta 1, theta 2, N1 and N2 as follows. N1 into sine of theta 1 is equal to N2 into sine of theta 2. So this is my basic equation of Snell's law. Now consider the case of raindrop. So let's say this is my raindrop. Yes, something like that, almost something like that. This is my raindrop, this is the center of it. It's called the center home. So the light is coming from sun, parallel rays of light are coming from the sun. So suppose this is the light. This is the light which is coming from the sun. Okay, so let's go a little bit lower. So here is the incident. Now at this point it is air outside and here it is water. So when light goes from air to water, water is denser, refractive index is 1.33, air is rarer, refractive index is 1. So light will bend towards the normal. Okay, so how to find the normal? Just draw a line from center to this point. This is my normal. Now it will bend towards the normal, so let's say this light ray will go like this. Okay, so I am calling this as my angle I and this as my angle R. Now I am calling this point A, this point let's say call it B. At B point, now the basic question is what will happen at B point? Is this rainbow formation due to total internal reflection or simply a reflection at a point? So first let's complete the ray diagram. At this point again draw a normal. If this is angle R, so this is the radius of the circle OA, and OB it is also the radius of the circle. So angle opposite to equal sides are equal, so this angle is also R. And if this angle is R, so whether it is reflection or total internal reflection, the laws of reflection are valid. Angle of incidence is same as angle of reflection. So at this surface, R is my angle of incidence. So light ray will reflect like this. So this angle is also R. Okay. But the confusion is still there, whether it is due to total internal reflection, means none of the light which is coming from A to B, none nothing of that light goes out into the air and all the light energy that reflects back into the same medium, or just it is simply a reflection in which some part of the light is reflected and a part of light goes into the air. So let's say suppose for total internal reflection, what are the conditions for total internal light should go from denser medium to rarer medium? That is one thing. And another thing is angle of incidence is greater than critical. Okay, so what is angle of incidence? Critical angle. Suppose this is the two medium, this is the normal. So if the light ray is incident at a such an angle, such that after refraction it goes parallel to the surface, like this. This is the incident ray. This is refracted. So what is angle of incidence? Angle of incidence is I, and this is angle of refraction, which is 90. And this is denser medium. This is denser, and this is rarer. So when the light goes from denser to rarer medium in such a way, that angle of incidence, there is some angle of incidence for which angle of reflection is 90 degree, that is called IC, critical angle. And for total internal reflection to happen, the angle of incidence is greater than critical. Only then T.I.R will take place, otherwise. And of course, most important, the light should go from denser to rarer. Okay, so now let's check in this case whether T.I.R will take place or not. At this point, let's use that equation. N1 into sin theta 1 means refractive index of first medium into incidence angle in the first medium. So the ray is coming from water to air. Refractive index of water is 1.33. So N1 into sin theta 1 is equal to N2 into sin theta 2. And taking a case in which the angle R is such that after refraction the light goes like this. Okay, the light ray goes inside the water drop like this. And when it is refracted, I am taking the extreme case in which the angle of refraction is 90 degree. So when I use this equation, N1 is 1.33, sin theta 1 is nothing but R, so sin R, N2, which is the refractive index of air, that is 1, into sin of theta 2, this angle theta 2 is 90 degree, and we know that sin 90 is 1. Now, let's calculate the value of sin R. So sin R is 1 divided by 1.33. So obviously it comes out to be sin R is equal to something like 0.752. All these calculations are for this surface, this point. So if I want to that my light ray after refraction it becomes tangent to the point B, then this R should be in such a way that sine of that R is equal to 0.752. Now these two angles, this angle and this angle, they are equal. So whether I calculate sine of R for this or sine of R for this, they are same. Okay, so for this sine of R, let's calculate what should be value of angle of incidence I at point A. So this calculation is at point B. Now let's calculate at point A. So at point A, Again, apply Snell's law. N1 into sine theta 1. Okay, let me write this once again, Snell's law. N1 into sine theta 1 is equal to N2 into sine theta 2. So, what is N1? Is the refractive index of first medium. What is N2? Refractive index of second medium. What is theta 1? Angle made by the light ray with the normal in first medium. And what is theta 2? Angle made by the light ray with respect to normal in second medium. So, with these definitions, let's apply Snell's law at this point. So, N1, light is coming from air to water. So, air to water, air refractive index N1 is 1 and angle of incidence is I. N2, what is N2? N2 is 1.33 and this is sine theta 2. What is theta 2? Is R. What is sine R? Sine R is 0.75. So sine I is equal to 1.33 into 0.752. So it implies sine I, it is approximately equal to 1.0016. So 1.33 into 0.752, this is close to 1.0016. So it means the angle of incidence I is equal to sine inverse 1.0016. But this equation is telling you all these conditions, all these things will take place. The light ray at the point B will go tangent when sine R is 0.752. But when sine R is 0.752, your sine I should be 1.0016. At that point, the light ray will go like this. But we know that there is no such angle exist for which the value of sine is greater than 1. There is no such angle for which the value of sine is greater than 1. So sine I is equal to 1.006. It is impossible. Because the maximum value of sine is 1, that is at 90 degree. Okay, and if the angle is less than 90 degree, then the value of sine is less. For example, for 30 degree, the sine 30 is 0.5. For 45 degree, sine 45 is 1 over root 2. For 60 degree, it is root 3 by 2. So all these numbers are less than 1. And the maximum value of sine which you get is 1. So, ये कंडीशन हमें बता रही है कि अगर आप चाहते हो कि जो लाइट रे है वो ड्रॉप से जाए और उसके बाद सरफेस से परपेंडिकुलरली ग्रेस करती हुई जाए, तो उसके लिए जो एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस है उसके साइन का वैल्यू 1.0016 होना चाहिए, जो कि पॉसिबल ही नहीं है. और इस सिचुएशन में भी हम ये कह सकते हैं कि ये TIR नहीं है. एंगल ऑफ आर जो है वो इससे ज्यादा होना चाहिए, तब जाके TIR होगा. एंगल आर उसका ज्यादा होना मतलब जब आप एंगल बढ़ाते हो देन इंक्रीज द आर, द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन आर आल्सो इंक्रीजेस. सो इन दिस इक्वेशन व्हेन यू इंक्रीज द साइन आर, दिस वाज साइन आर 1 एंड 1.33 इज फिक्स्ड. तो साइन आई वो भी बढ़ना चाहिए, और अगर साइन आई बढ़ना चाहिए तो क्रिटिकल एंगल के लिए ही साइन आई है वो इम्पॉसिबल है, तो उससे ज्यादा क्या बढ़ाओ. ओके, तो ये जो रिजल्ट है ये बिल्कुल भी पॉसिबल नहीं है. दैट वैल्यू ऑफ साइन आई इज इक्वल टू 1.0016 बिकॉज वी कैनॉट गो मोर देन 1 फॉर एनी एंगल ऑफ साइन. इवन इफ यू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन ऑफ 1 लाख, इट इज less than 1. The maximum you can do is plus 1 for sine. Okay, so that's why there is
no TIR in the rainbow. There is no TIR. जिस भी बुक में, जिस भी वेबसाइट में, जहां पर भी इंटरनेट रिसोर्सेस पे, जिस भी ब्लॉग में, यूट्यूब की जिस भी वीडियो में अगर ये लिखा हुआ है कि रेनबो के अंदर TIR होती है, वो बिल्कुल गलत है। ठीक है, फिर क्या होता है TIR नहीं होती। तो यहां पर लाइट जो है, अब हम इसको ऐसे समझ सकते हैं कि ए पॉइंट पे जब लाइट पड़ेगी, इस इंसिडेंट लाइट का कुछ हिस्सा होगा वो रिफ्लेक्ट कर देगा और इसी इंसिडेंट लाइट का कुछ हिस्सा होगा वो रिफ्लेक्ट कर देगा। और सिमिलरली पॉइंट बी पे, एट पॉइंट बी अ पार्ट ऑफ इंसिडेंट लाइट, दिस रे ए बी, अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस इंसिडेंट रे इज should go like this if there is no change in medium. So a part of this is refracted and a part of this ray is reflected here. Okay, and you can repeat the same procedure at this point also. Let's call this point C. So again, draw a normal. So this ray BC, a part of ray BC is refracted, so this is the actual ray, this is the normal, this is the ray, so it will bend away from the normal, so this is normal, so away from the normal, so ray will go like this. And again at this point also, at C point, a part of this ray will be reflected. Okay, so this light will reflect this like this. याद रखना है, इसको लेके कोई कंफ्यूजन नहीं होनी चाहिए कि रेनबो में TIR होती है या नहीं। रेनबो में TIR बिल्कुल नहीं होती है। रेनबो में केवल और केवल तीन फिनोमेना है जो रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट, रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट एंड डिस्पर्शन।